Hi, I'm Wayne Allyn for Personal Liberty. I'm very clear on what's killing America. First, it's Obama and his socialist cabal. Even worse than socialist, most of them are Marxist. Second, it's the lying politicians of both parties. They lie to cover up their true agenda and they lie to cover up their incompetence. Third, it's the lying media, up to their necks in a cover-up to support Obama and his destruction of the middle class and small business. Lastly, here's the good one, it's the moderate GOP establishment in Washington, D.C. They are fraternizing with the enemy. They don't care about us. They're all good buddies in D.C., BFFs, best friends forever, in bed together with a common cause, getting reelected, guaranteeing their old golden parachute, and setting their kids up for life, all at the expense of the rest of us and our kids. Lies are killing America. Everyone in D.C. lies to trick us, distract us, and confuse us. Pretty soon, no one even knows what the truth is anymore. And the biggest lie is from Obama and moderate Republicans and the mainstream media, all in bed together trying to convince us that only moderation, cooperation, and compromise can save the GOP and America. This is one of the greatest lies ever told. First of all, moderation won't save the GOP. Nothing could be further from the truth. The fact is the GOP has had a long list of moderate saviors. Gerald Ford, loser. Bob Dole, loser. George H.W. Bush, loser. John McCain, loser. Mitt Romney, loser. And we can also add George W. Bush to this list because his moderation on spending led to the election of Barack Obama. So much for moderation winning elections for the GOP. The reality is the Republican Party has elected only one true conservative as president ever. His name was Ronald Reagan. I was there when my liberal friends at Columbia University called Reagan loony, nutty, extreme, radical right-wing nutcase, and out of touch. Well, that radical right-wing nutcase won in two massive presidential landslides. And how about Reagan's results? This one true conservative president ever brought America back from the brink of total economic collapse, decline, malaise, and misery. Reagan turned the worst economy since 1929 into the greatest economic expansion in world history. Reagan created 20 million jobs during his term, and then the 20 uninterrupted years of economic expansion that Reagan started created 40 million jobs and trillions in wealth. The mainstream media is desperate to make all of you forget that. You know what else the media doesn't want us to remember? That Reagan wanted massive cuts to spending. But in the end, he listened to the media and compromised. He agreed to increase spending to get his tax cuts that saved the U.S. economy. Now Democrats and the media use that compromise to destroy Reagan's legacy by claiming Reagan raised spending and built huge deficits. Well, then I guess compromise is bad for Republicans, isn't it? You know what else the media doesn't want us to remember? Reagan cut income taxes from 70% to 28%. But then once again, he listened to the media and he compromised. He allowed a few small tax increases in order to get Democrats to agree to future spending cuts. Now the media accuses Reagan of raising taxes multiple times. And of course, the Democrats lied and never cut any of the spending that they agreed to in order to get those tax increases. So I guess compromise is bad for Republicans, isn't it? You know what else the media doesn't want us to remember? That George H.W. Bush compromised on his promise, read my lips, no new taxes. Once again, in order to get Democrats to rein in spending, Bush compromised. Once again, Democrats lied and cheated. No spending was cut, but Bush got the blame for raising taxes. So I guess compromise is bad for Republicans, isn't it? And when George W. Bush compromised by letting spending grow unchecked and never vetoed a single spending bill, we got an economic crisis, the banking system almost collapsed, the debt plunged us into a depression, and Obama was elected. Gee, compromise really works out well for Republicans, doesn't it? But wait, there's more proof that this idea of moderation is a stone-cold failure. The GOP ran nothing but moderates for Congress throughout the 50s, 60s, 70s, and even 80s. The result was a permanent Democratic majority in Congress from 1954 through 1994. Moderation resulted in 40 years of unchallenged domination for Democrats. The facts are in. When Republicans compromise their principles, allow bigger spending, agree to tax increases, support bigger government, and become nothing more than Democrat light, they lose. Then, of course, there's the most powerful proof of all, the 2010 election. Led by the energy and passion of the Tea Party, Republicans achieved the most smashing victory in political history. They not only won Congress in the biggest landslide since 1938, they took a majority of governorships, but also won the most state legislative seats since 1928. The media seems to have overlooked or forgotten about this, even though it only happened 4 short years ago. after that record-setting Tea Party victory, with polls showing the Tea Party more popular by far than the actual Republican Party itself, politicians of both parties in D.C. panicked. They couldn't allow the country to be dominated by this idea of smaller government. Everyone in D.C. gets rich off big government. They couldn't afford to let the gravy train slow down. So Obama and his socialist cabal, with a great big assist from big government rhino Republicans, set about to destroy the Tea Party. The plan was to slander them, distract them, intimidate them, and destroy them. It took a coordinated criminal conspiracy, some might call it racketeering, by Obama, Democrats, big government politicians of both parties, the mainstream media, and most importantly, the IRS. Democrats call conservative patriots terrorists, arsonists, radical, extreme, and even worse. The media quoted them all day and night, and the IRS set out to intimidate, harass, and persecute Tea Party groups and conservative critics of the president, like me, until their energy was killed, their passion sapped, their views silenced, and their fundraising starved. Suddenly, with true conservatives distracted, persecuted, and on the defensive, and on the run, and a wonderful moderate like Mitt Romney at the top of the ticket, it was back to mediocrity and the Losers Club for the GOP. Do you see a pattern developing? Moderate equals loser. This is what Democrats and the media want to convince us to go back to. Could it be that the media desperately wants to convince us that a moderate will save the GOP simply because they know a moderate will guarantee a Democratic victory? But moderation, cooperation, and compromise doesn't just lead to GOP mediocrity and defeat. It also leads to ruination for the nation, for the United States of America. The proof's in the pudding. We've had decades of cooperation and compromise and moderation on Capitol Hill. The result? $17 trillion in debt. When you add in unfunded liabilities, well over $100 to $200 trillion in debt, no one's quite sure. All that cooperation and business as usual has produced a bankrupt nation, the death of full-time good-paying jobs, and the extinction of the middle class. Moderation, cooperation, and compromise have killed the greatest nation and the greatest economic juggernaut in world history. If all that hasn't convinced you, how about some eye-opening facts provided by my friends at the Congressional Effect Fund? In the past half century, since 1964, when Congress was in session, the U.S. stock market has been up 1%. And during that same time period, when Congress was on recess, the stock market was up 17%. So tell me what the benefit is of moderation and cooperation. The reality is, no matter who is sitting in those seats on Capitol Hill, politicians are doing damage to our economy each time they compromise and each time they agree to pass a bill. Still not convinced? How about over a 100-year timeline? Again, courtesy of my friends at the Congressional Effect Fund. If you'd invested $1 in the stock market in 1899, only when Congress was in their seats, today you'd have $2. If you invested the same dollar only when Congress was in recess, today you'd have $300. More proof that moderation, cooperation, and compromise are greatly overrated. We don't need a moderate GOP to save the Republican Party or America. History actually proves that compromise leads to deficit, debt, and economic decline. The solution? We need to throw all the bums out. Every single one of them. Clean house. Then start over with Tea Party conservatives with the same limited government principles as our great founding fathers. They should be citizen politicians willing to make government smaller, make themselves less powerful, and restore power to the people. They should all agree that government feels our pain only because government's the one causing it. Government can't run the post office without losing $16 billion a year, and that's with no competition mandated by law. Government runs Amtrak. It's lost $40 billion in counting, and still we lose about $30 every time a butt sits on an Amtrak seat. Government runs the $16 trillion war on poverty that wasted and lost the whole $16 trillion. Government runs our failing public schools. From now on, if a politician thinks government knows best or government has the answer, they must be defeated no matter what party he or she represents. Oh, and one other thing. From this day forward, we've got to term limit the politicians. Limit them all to 2 terms, 1 term in office and 1 term in prison. I call it the Chicago rule. I'm Wayne Allyn for Personal Liberty. See you next week, same time, same place. God bless America and save us from rhino Republicans who sell us out and therefore compromise not only our principles, but our economy and our children's future. Bye-bye.